You're listening to the Court of Public Opinion. Attention all hunters, deer season over the road. Make sure you have your proper hunting and fishing license with you. More after this here at the Court of Public Opinion. You can also look to some more broadcasts coming up soon. I changed over the Court of Public Opinion because I knew exactly what was going to end up happening. So last year we prepared for this in Off the Grid Post, and they had a contingency plan years ago, and what they were doing was disarming everyone. They were making up a lot of accusations, mentally abusing some of us, and then turn around taking our gun rights away from us. We're veterans, number one, and number two, we're trained. And when I was watching the news headlines about these specific topics, including what happened at Fort Hood and what was the gun running issue up there on the border, after having dealt with probation officers and after being a rape victim myself and being disarmed, they're going to have to argue this case over again. Because personally, when the victims are raped and assaulted and disarming victims, they are going to lose their gun control argument. Families and victims, what they were doing is they were using the domestic violence propaganda against the judge, okay? Because they know that he's going to argue this case. This case is going to be argued in court at the Supreme Court level. There are several victims out there who have been victimized over all kinds of reasons. They cannot start disarming Americans every day for every reason in the world. It just doesn't work like that. And in fact, what it does is what it sends a message is that more people are going to start carrying guns for that reason. That's why the gun control people are actually doing more. It's actually more beneficial every time they try to push the gun control. It just means more people are going to be more armed because of it. And the more guns out here, the more smarter that people carry and either carry license and actually, yeah, absolutely. They've been disarming victims. We've been sexually assaulted the whole time. We've been assaulted the whole time. And they were trying to disarm us. And we're the victims of the abuse. So there's a lot to be said at the Court of Public Opinion. There's a lot to be said at the Hunter's Lounge. And there's much more coming up next. Thank you very much. Fortunately, having talked to Chance and having talked to the Hagmans and many other broadcast journalists and also individuals that are in this region, we can share their own concerns. What I was concerned about from the day I moved back here is that in Missouri, we can carry, not here in Pennsylvania. And they've been pushing the gun control issue here. And Project Pennsylvania is exactly why we're fighting back. They've been sexually assaulting and using bondage videos and rape and S&M and abuse issues all through this period. And there's all kinds of other things going on in that region. And they were disarming us in the process. They wouldn't even talk about the Project Pennsylvania. We wouldn't even talk about the raping and abusing of children as they're sitting there disarming us. And my grandfather was the attorney for the Pittsburgh Police. Imagine that. Honestly, if they're going to go after us, they're probably going to go after the police. They're going to go after everybody else. And I mean, we're the only time we ever really needed to carry a gun is a service weapon. And that's the whole reason. Because I'm a paramedic by trade. I'm a medic by trade. So I know that if I have a patient that's in an emergency, I have to carry a service weapon. So they start disarming us and they start saying, well, no, because I can tell you firsthand, we're in it to save lives. That the reason we carry a gun is for defensive purposes, to protect the victims. That's the whole reason. And we ended up getting assaulted. And I have the police reports to prove it. As a review, you have to listen to the argument. They're disarming the rape victims that are pro-gun. They'll only elect the victims up there in Washington, D.C. that are social justice warriors. Meaning there are domestic violence victims that believe in gun rights. Meaning all these victims are not all social justice warriors. In fact, that was the reason most of the victims weren't getting help. They were making it political at these shelters that they would not let the victims carry guns to protect themselves and their children. Meaning most of the women that I deal with are victims of domestic violence, carry a gun because they were raped. And why is it that they would disarm them? Because it's exactly what's been going on in a lot of the shelters and programs. They don't want women to carry guns, or there's got to be some justification because it's a social justice agenda. what's going on in these shelters and welfare and access, the same thing. Mm-hmm. That's why this argument is very relevant. Uh-huh. They started disarming a lot of women. Mm-hmm. They disarmed a lot of women, and we're the ones that were left home alone without no one to protect us or keep us safe. Mm-hmm. And that, to me, there's real harm when they start disarming single mothers who and single women. Mm-hmm. Who are protecting their children, and they would purposely go out of the way to isolate us and mentally abuse us. Mm-hmm. Purposely. It's called harassment. What makes it even worse than the harassment is that my brothers and my sisters were abuse victims to begin with. Uh-huh. And that's why the foster care issues got to be addressed. Uh-huh. They cannot abuse kids like that. Uh-huh. Mentally abuse children this way. Mm-hmm. And I think if the foster parents want to be get honest, why they got an attitude the way they did, because they were on defense the whole time. This is a very relevant when it comes to foster children and finding out that there was a foster parent hitting and smacking and rubbing themselves in front of the kids, and somebody was acting out on us. This is really relevant. What's going on right here in this building? In fact, we can protest on our porch here. Welcome to the Porchville Talk Show. After this, as you're listening to Amateur Radio Network, make sure that you have your proper license with you anyway. Because these people, first of all the restrictions that are put on legal gun users, yes, legal gun users, for all the restrictions that were put on us, and then to disarm us and turn around, because I passed all the background checks. Long before this all started, I passed all my criminal background checks. There's got to be more checks in the system, because this whole gun control measure was done purposely. They disabled us this way. This is what they mean by disabled vehicles. That was a moving violation, by the way. Meaning, when somebody has the Second Amendment right and they pass all their background checks, they go through all the proper procedures only to disarm them. Uh-huh. That's really what's been going on. Uh-huh. And they sent us to court, and then they make us do a plea bargain. That's what happened in 2016. Uh-huh. I'm a U.S. soldier and veteran, and I pass all my background checks, and I'm the victim of domestic violence, and then you disarm me. That's how it is. The only reason, only time, yeah. See, these people been assaulting us the whole time, and they tried to disarm us at the same time. So they rape and assault us, and then turn around and disarm us. Mm-hmm. I stand with Brett Kavanaugh. That's what these women did. They use the propaganda, the domestic violence propaganda, and they say that all these women were victims. They come out, suddenly they're all victims. That's what's been the argument the whole time, and why we went to the shelters and we talked to the police. They all turn around, they'll act like nothing's wrong, and then they'll use that social justice agenda, and they'll pull that bullcrap. And why there's going to be changes, and why we want detectives and start working in some of the shelters, is so they don't disarm detectives and police. And that's what's been going on for almost 40 years. Actually, this has been going on that long. Mm-hmm. And domestic violence victims don't want to be disarmed. In fact, that's the whole reason women carry a gun, because of that very reason. And that's what they were doing. They were disarming the families. Mm-hmm. We're the victims to begin with. That's why I listen to Pam Geller and I listen to Judge Beery, because they're exactly right. That's exactly what the problem is. You're talking about Judge Pura, who is the one who created the domestic violence program to begin with. You're talking about Pam Geller. Mm-hmm. We are like that. We are the victims of this. We are just like Pam Geller and Judge Pura. And they're disarming us. Mm-hmm. We're the ones that are standing out against Islam and Jihad. I served my country. I have to be that much more careful. They sold our information. We're veterans. Uh-huh. We have to carry guns. Because they did this to U.S. soldiers. They sent personal information, and they were sending us a message. Last year, December, while we were on Amtrak, they were sending us all kinds of messages, including on Pizzagate. And they say it's not an issue. It's a criminal conspiracy. Not Pizzagate. The word Pizzagate it's been overused. It's a criminal conspiracy, and it's a cabal of violent abuse against children and families using the CYS system, using all these programs to put fear tactics in these families to make them shut up, including that Archibald stuff that they're doing. It's sick shit. Uh-huh. And that's how the people are going to win. Uh-huh. That's why they were trying to intervene and do something about it. Uh-huh. Because Brett Kavanaugh is the judge. Thank you. Okay, so as a review and a wrap-up here at the Court of Public Opinion, what we have shared and discussed just on the radio waves, because believe me, what goes on this radio wave, and we're tuning in on frequency, believe me, because this discussion is going to be very relevant. And talking on the porch at Porchville, you can join in whether you want, or if you like to just shoot the breeze. There are a lot of relevant topics on the gun control issue. Now, I can hear both sides. I'm willing to hear both sides, and I want other people to chime in. What you think about gun control, why do you think that gun control is being pushed? Well, for the very same reasons that it was pushed in Australia, for the same reasons that they're having problems in the London, UK, the beheading incident alone, and why we support a Brexit. Because silence is consent. And if you silence London, and you silence the gun owners in London, you silence Australia, and you silence Germany, to me, that's exactly why Brexit, all exits. Believe me when I say silencing Aussies and silencing the gun owners throughout the parts of the world is exactly what the concern is. They started silencing these people, and Brexit is just as relevant as it was the day it started. It is that relevant. They started silencing the media in other parts of the world on the issue on guns. The more guns most people have, the less likely those violent acts will be committed. And that's why they were trying to silence them to begin with. Because they silence would be consent. It would be like those people are consenting to be abused. So break the silence on abuse and domestic violence. Thank you very much. Definitely don't try it on me. Because see, in Pennsylvania, the Project Pennsylvania is very relevant. We got to hear back. We're going to be running for different elected positions, and I know that there's some people out here are concerned about who's going to run for governor in the local elections, so pay attention to local elections, including who's running for governor, because we need an outcry, because that Project Pennsylvania is relevant to every Pennsylvania who has children and children that have been sexually abused, and what's going on in the Catholic Church should be the biggest issue right now here in Pennsylvania. As we speak, thousands of children and families have been sexually abused, and there's going to be a real outcry by the time we get to Harrisburg. We want governors to not only defend families and children, but sit down and say, this enough's enough. I would include, I'll write in Rick Santorum. Thank you very much. I can honestly tell you that as I speak for most of you, I will share this, and that's exactly what's going on. Also, I spoke to Representative Daryl Metcalf's office and other representatives who were coming against that legislation in Pennsylvania that they're trying to stiff arm and try to push this agenda, more gun control here in Pennsylvania. And yeah, you remember when Barack Obama said that we were bitter clingers? Uh-huh. Well, hey, guess what? They're trying to push that bitter clinger thing over the this is what's going on in the state house right now, state representative's office. That they were pushing gun control on you, disarming you over the domestic violence propaganda. This is propaganda. They're using the social justice warriors as the victims. And I'm a victim of domestic violence, and I have the criminal background checks and paperwork to prove it. And you know how they were leaving us on the highway at The Voice and other shelters, or other victims out here saying the same thing? That is relevant to what is going on. They better prove those victims, those quote victims, the social justice victims, they better prove their case in court. Well, what happened in Erie County last year really does matter, because there's juvenile sex offenders, there's adult sex offenders, there's offenders everywhere. And what they're doing is they're using the sex offenders to assault us. And they're registered sex offenders. So whatever's going on, it's very dark and it's very crooked. And what they were doing to a lot of political, you realize that the agenda to silence the best of the best, how they're silencing real families who are actually really connected. How bad it really is. I mean, we're talking about legitimate, good political people, too. They're trying to silence it. Listen, as soon as they started talking about killing and murdering doctors on YouTube, it was very relevant. When you hear about families, literally, like, when I see in therapy, the floaters, the floating devices, what was going on in a marina down in McKees Rocks, and bodies literally, it's very relevant. Keep your gun rights. Protect your gun rights. It's very relevant. Everyone needs to be armed out there. They don't need to be leaving their families vulnerable or an unnecessary harm. Make sure you have, you pack some powder and have a peacemaker with you. See, President Trump is very great and gracious enough to allow us to have a platform to do that. And I thank you. Because there are other members who are going to discuss what needs to be discussed. And a 12-person panel, absolutely. Because in a hunt club, if they were to hunt us down, like hunt us through the woods, like what's that movie they have out? The Hunger Games. Yeah, that's how we've been living. Hunger Games. Meaning they were hunting us down like prey. And we can't carry a gun. You can think again. That's what the word is on the street. They were disarming us and treating us like prey. So we're not the predators, by the way. We're the victims. And we need to have a peace. Yeah, we do. We need to have the peacemaker, and you got to train on a peacemaker. Thank you very much. You're listening to the Court of Public Opinion. I am so grateful that you all are here when you are here at this moment. Because if it hadn't been for us making a phone call and listening to Butler Radio, I don't know that we even know about it. And pay attention to the local elections. Pay attention, kids. And make sure, don't tread on me. Because that snake has been after us on the issues of tobacco and some other things as well. Don't tread on me, kids. Get it. Got it good. Silence is consent. Do not consent to it. Break the silence on abuse. Break the silence on child abuse. Do not go fall victim to abuse. Don't let those people get away with it. Speak out. Speak out on your porches, protests in your neighborhoods, protests at the county courthouse. The louder our voices, the better it is. Don't tread on me, kids. Got it? You're listening to the Court of Public Opinion, Hunt Club, and all. Support the NRA. Much more coming up next. Members of the NRA definitely want to chime into this because that's exactly what's going on in Pennsylvania right now as we speak. Make sure you have your hunting license and gun license with you. Make sure you pack some powder and that peacemaker. Most of the issues that were introduced to us years ago is that they were trying to push us down that road again. And I'm going to tell you, liberal or progressive or Democrat or Republican, it wouldn't matter. Your gun rights are your gun rights. Those are things that are given to you, unalienable rights. Those are constitutional rights. It wouldn't matter what political agenda they were trying to push. That's a constitutional right. That's a bill of rights. That's why soldiers get in uniform, to protect the rights, so you guys can speak out. That is the primary reason most people get in uniform. And that is as relevant to me as anybody else. Now, I could see how they pushed the agenda. I could see how that was. But initially, when you push comes to shove and you're on the field and and you're there to save someone's life, yes, you have to carry a piece. In a war situation, yeah. As a paramedic, yeah. A service weapon, yeah, absolutely. You have to be trained as well, yeah. They have to know what to do. It's called saving lives. That's the whole reason paramedics carry guns. That's exactly what was going on. They're going to clear up a lot of issues. It's going to get cleared up. As far as educators and teachers as well, listen, we're going to leave it over to these dudes here. NRA has argued this case. These are the people that need to discuss it. They are the legal gun owners. They have passed all legal background checks. That's fine with me because disarming victims, to me, is really ludicrous. Yeah. We'll be back after this. Stay tuned for more broadcasts of the Court of Public Opinion because I think there's a lot of victims out there that have yet to be speak out about the rape of men and women and children. That's the whole deal. That's a whole issue. That's a reason you carry a gun. That's a reason you carry a holster. I mean, this is just common sense. It's common sense. I will listen to the common sense show. Listen to these broadcasters. Listen to AMTV. Yeah, carry a gun. Yeah, and know what to do. Know how to defend yourself and your family. If it's not a rocket launcher, it'll be something else. If it's not anything could be a weapon. The irony of this is that they're considered. That's why the whole AR-15 argument is irrelevant. They could take a shovel and hit somebody and kill somebody. They're not going to start banning shovels. They're not going to start banning pogo sticks or pots and pans or knives and forks. I mean, if we get to that point, I mean, we would be confined to what we've been confined to. Meaning, that's what they do in these institutions. They institutionalize people, and that's exactly why the problem, that's why it's so important to support Israel, no matter what you say. What happened to the Jewish people, they disarmed the Jewish people the same way. This is what they did to Jewish people. That's why Israel is freaking most of people in Israel pack powder because of that very reason. And they're doing it to Americans. And this time, because of what happened in Israel, that it won't happen in America if we're smart enough to pay attention. More after this at the Court of Public Opinion. We sat there in 2013 and watched how many Jewish women were assaulted. And Yazidis, why the Yazidis were lined up there for that reason, for that same reason we're lined up here. It's no different. It would be no different in Syria. It would be no different. It would be no different what happened to us, if it happened to the Coptic Christians or not. It would be no different. The assault on women, Yazidis. I'm for the Yazidis 125%. You can make that 300%. I'm all for it. Yeah. They want the 72 virgins. So you might see their virgins really quickly. Let's get back to more topics like the Court of Public Opinion. There's so much here. This is your forum. You can speak out. You be the judge. You decide on what you think is important here. And when it comes to the issue on guns, yeah. It's good to get a consensus and idea because that's really what the election's right now about. You want to make sure your children and your family are safer today. That's the whole deal. I'm not arguing that there aren't shelters that have concerns when it comes to guns. I have concerns that they would victimize the victims this way. I think that's a really important... They're crime victims first. That's why the detectives have to look into this matter. And yes, the NRA needs to argue this case. You cannot disarm the victims and turn around and call yourself the victim. You follow me? More after this. You're listening to... We're going to have a review and a summary and discuss a lot more after this. You're listening to a special broadcast here at We Are Family Therapy Radio. And the therapy part is that a lot of us who have had injuries do need medical care. And I hope that you can support us by going to our link below here in the description box. Please click like and subscribe. So much more up next. And there is a fashion show on Wednesday, October 11th. And I hope that we get a chance to get to that event. We've been working hard towards getting to other events, and we've been kind of sick for a while, so it's good to know that maybe some of us might be sensing a turnaround here. Really, I'm noticing it's a noticeable turnaround. So hopefully very soon we'll be able to get to those events, and I know that's important. Ladies Night Out at the Butler Country Club. Stay tuned for more. You're listening to Amateur Radio Network. You do not have to be a voice in the wilderness. You can speak out and meet us here at the Court of Public Opinion here in Portugal. We have a lot to say about much more. Coming soon. Much more. Thank you. You're welcome. I knew this was going to happen a year ago because of what happened in Ambridge, that to disarm teachers, to me, that would be the next issue that's going to be taken up. I would not put it past the gun control people to push sexual abuse in the media. I would not put it past any of the propagandists used out there to push gun control. I would not. After being a victim of it, I would not be surprised. In fact, I think there's a lot of teachers and families out there who have been victimized by that mental health agenda. Mm-hmm. And that's really what I'm trying to think of all the doctors that we listen to on radio about that. Initially, why we started this post to begin with is because of this issue that you're hearing about on the news, and why I started the therapy program part of it, because I think there is benefits to talking about it, and on Saturday morning, a broadcast like that would be very great, and there's other topics I want to cover as well. So when we discuss cases or concerns, that we gotta make sure that there's some things that get cleared up before we do that. Meaning it has to go through some, you know, background stuff itself. So, because I'll be honest with you, there's a lot of topics can be tackled. And being an open forum is one thing because it's open source. The other topics I think are going to be relevant are the ones that you're going to hear of in the next couple of years, especially right now, as we're going to watch and see what the cases that'll be. Going forward, as far as I'm concerned, an open source information is all available online, and that's very much important. Now, what I like about the cryptocurrency, what I like about all that, is that it offers you flexibility, gives you diversity. So there's some things we're going to talk about in Financial Times and things like that as well. But why I created this post, why I created some of the other work that I'm doing, is because of this very reason. We need to have a voice when it comes to elections, especially what's going on right now in Pennsylvania. This is why we're back here. Mm-hmm. So you can join in at any time if you feel comfortable to discuss it. We can listen to all versions and concerns, because I know that there's going to be some other individuals that might disagree. Mm-hmm. And that's okay. We're allowed to disagree. Mm-hmm. Now, what's going to happen at this point from now till the election, it remains to be seen. Who we're going to vote for. Believe me, when I say I'm for what Trump is doing, I mean it. I'm not going to change my mind. When it comes to that, when it comes to every issue that we're seeing, there's no flip-flopping on this. We mean what we say, and we say what we mean. Taking gun rights away from veterans and families like that, families need to protect themselves, especially after what's happened on the border. Thank you for listening to our broadcast. More up this, up next. The reason we started the coffee shop part of it is because they wouldn't serve veterans coffee at Starbucks. So that's why we have a coffees for sale, $1 a cup. Thank you. Please support us. And it's basically because of what happened with the coffee. They would not serve veterans at Starbucks. So that's why we have a coffee house. Mm-hmm. Thank you for supporting us. At any rate, it is important. Also, if you guys are looking for healthmasters.com, that's one of the doctors that was referring to about some of the health issues we were experiencing. So one of those things is a lot of the life hacks and things that we were going to talk about. Yeah, there's a lot to say that. Much more coming up next. We are Family Therapy Radio. Mm-hmm. And then the Court of Public Opinion. Congrats, Judge Brett Kavanaugh. Thank you. You're listening to the Court of Public Opinion. Yeah, this is our coffee hut. This is the coffee hut. This is where we sell coffee, right here. So if you don't know where we're at and you need a cup of coffee, just let us know. And just a cup of coffee, it helps us keep us ourselves self-supporting. And we are publicly supported because of our coffee. And we are by supporting us in our t-shirts. This is our coffee hut. And what I want to do is try to franchise this out for other veterans and families to own and operate their own coffee hut. And putting together a franchise package which would allow families to not only support themselves, but able to basically do it with the upstart fees that are very low cost. That's kind of where we're headed with it. And because of what Starbucks did, this is the response. Our response and our rebuttal for the way veterans and families have been treated. That is our rebuttal. More after this, you're listening to the Court of Public Opinion. You're listening to the Court of Public Opinion. More up next at We Are Family Therapy Radio, 10-4. Copperhead Road. And dad ran a whiskey in a big black bag. The issues on individual rights and personhood are going to be really relevant to.
Oh, I have to listen to this anyway. Quite a public opinion.
She kissed me and said, baby.
again, supporting our coffee house is really important. Stay tuned for more. With disarming veterans and then leaving us homeless and then we can't even afford to live in a house. Really, the veterans are the first lines of on offense and defense. You put us out in there in the front lines and then disarm them. That's the whole issue. And then turn around and not serve veterans coffee. Mm. That's why we have a coffee shop. Mm. For this very reason. They wouldn't even allow us to have basically a job. We actually had to start our own business because we could not operate our home and feed our own families. Mm. We were left homeless and stranded with no money, no gas, no food. And we're the very veterans that go out there and defend our country. So please, support us. Because silence is consent, and that's the truth. Thank you for listening to the Court of Public Opinion. There's more coming up next. The word was shared throughout this land. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people, whether they choose to believe it or not, it's not the question. The word of God is true. And there's a lot of debates right now whether America is a Christian nation or not. There's parts of this world that I do not believe are Christian any more than the United States. What we stand for on when it comes to house, and when it comes to combat issues, when combat-related injuries associated with domestic violence is no different than it would be in another part of the world. When somebody comes to violate your children or family, we're in combat mode. That's the way it is. They put on combat gear, they put on, they get SWAT teams and everything to protect families, especially because most family members are treated like POWs. We were a prisoner in our own household, so naturally calling SWAT team would be obviously the same thing. It would be no different than calling on the militia to back up the military. It would be no different than anything else. When somebody comes to assault your family, you want to be in combat mode. You want to have night vision. You want to have everything available to protect yourself and your family because they left us on the highway to begin with. You're listening to the Court of Public Opinion. We're coming up next. Thank you very much. Time for it. Do you know the long gun issue and the issues on guns is just as relevant as what the day it happened? It's just as relevant when I was assaulted that day, when I was sexually abused and abused and fondled and molested. Mm-hmm. Do you know it's relevant as 1986? It's just as relevant today. The issue on personhood, the issue on child abuse, the issue on protecting your children and why they have hospital lockdown. Because you heard stories about how there are vicious, savage, I wouldn't call it a woman or man who's savagely abusing a pregnant woman or anybody. Mm. To me, this is pregnant with problems that you cannot even imagine. Mm. Leaving somebody out in the street and highway with no food, no clothes, no nothing. We got gas money from the Zilly police to get to Kentucky just to get help. So yeah, silence is consent. We're not going to consent to abuse. And we're not going to stay silent. We're not going to go silent at night. And thank you for listening to the Court of Public Opinion. We're up next. You can see the individuals that are just as much relevant to what's going on in the dark. The kids that get lost out there. It's issues like movies and how previewing movies like The Lord of the Rings. Some other concerns that should be addressed. Yeah, what you should be watching, what you can't watch, and what you're allowed to watch. And having parents to sit there and review some of the stuff that we're watching. Because of what we see on TV, and because some of us have been in the dark and been lost on those issues, that's why we talk about it at the table. So to me, I mean, I'm not arguing one or the other. I just say you got to settle your concerns quickly. You don't ever let it like spill over. You have to sit down and communicate the concerns. Tell us what happened. If you can't, I mean, like somehow maybe write a message, send a card, put it in my mailbox, something. Send me something. Show me that you care about what's going on in Pennsylvania. At least that way we can acknowledge how to deal with it. And whether it's sign language, whether it's like, you know, speaking tongues, do what you have to do. Discuss it. And then one thing is to not be able to get a job in Pennsylvania while everybody's making money and making a decent living. That's why the system is the way it is. I mean, it is operated to fail. It's a system that eats itself. That's why we're looking at these other options in cryptocurrency. That's why we're looking at what AMTV is saying. That's why we look at and preview all this information. We go through several fact-checking stuff. And the fact that anybody would fact check us, like, to try to destroy our credibility online, I mean, to me, that's why operating our radio broadcasts and why we make sure our T's are crossed and our I's are dotted. Thank you. A lot more up next at the Court of Public Opinion. Issues on the cigarette rule or some issues at home, we can address right at the table. And then some issues with the candle, making sure that the lights are off and make sure the doors are locked up at night and making sure that, when we do basic special ops, do this. It would be no different at home. You do, security issues at home. Yeah. It's called operational security and situational awareness. Paying attention to what's going on around you, talking to your kids, talking to your brothers and sisters, discussing situational awareness. It is that way. Seeing that the kids would be lost out there and the next door neighbors and trying to find out what happened with the grass and some things. I mean, we got to talk to our kids. It's the way it is. We got nieces and nephews. We have medicine issues. The kids like the natural medicinals. In fact, the little girl she won't even take anything but the natural medicinals because she knows these kids are not stupid. Our little kids don't want to go along with the public school agenda, and they're agenda driven, and they push that agenda in the public schools. That's why the other option is homeschool. It's that simple, or private school. That's why parents are like, hey, I don't want to send my kids to a public school. It's going to push an agenda. And that's the same thing. It would be no different at the shelter. They're pushing an agenda like they are at the public school system. So we looked into a couple other things. So there's a lot of information to be shared, lots of topics, lots of things ahead. Stay tuned for more at the Court of Public Opinion. You're listening to Amateur Radio Network.
You've been listening to Amateur Radio Network.